In the ancient times, a long, long time ago, our ancestors knew that we were all connected. They knew that there were other people of different colors across the seas. And long before the Europeans came, our ancient ones knew that they were coming to this land. They knew that the Creator had given the colors of all these nations, of all these people over the seas, a special gift. Each color, the red man, the black man, the yellow man, and the white man, had special gifts, and each should be used to help each nation and each other. The white man is the keeper of the fire. They're the ones that have developed the weapons of the world and the guns. Things that go boom, bang, blow up buildings and cause all kinds of commotion with fire. But fire is also a healing element. It cleanses and purifies. Much good can come from fire. The white man is the keeper of the fire. The black man is the keeper of the water. In the desolate deserts of Africa, there isn't much water there, but these men know the precious use of it and know how to preserve it. The fluids of the body are water, and it is known that it was an African American who developed the processes of plasma within the body. The black man, keepers of the water. The yellow man, way in the far east, is keepers of the air. His ancient wisdom has given us understanding of the air, breathing, has given us meditation and knowing the power of the mind. They knew the power of the unseen through the air, healing, mind over matter. The yellow man is the keeper of the air. The red man, my ancestors indigenous to this continent, the indigenous men of the North, South, Central Americas, are the keepers of the earth. Since the beginning of time, our ancestors knew who we were and that what Mother Earth gives us for our survival. Nothing was ever taken without giving something back. Nothing was ever taken without giving thanks. Mother means giver of life. And without her, we could not exist. Take a deep breath. When you take a deep breath, it is that very breath that gave you life when you came here to begin your earth walk. The buildings that are constructed with wood and brick and steel all come from her. Steel makes our automobiles for transportation, even the fuel that we put in these automobiles. The oil, the refinement of that, it comes from Mother Earth. Everything that we eat is grown from this planet. Even the animals that are fed from her all come from Mother Earth. And when we're sick, the medicines come from the herbs that are grown on her soil. The water we drink, so vital to our survival, comes from her veins. So important that we keep the water pure. Even the beautiful ornaments we wear, like gold, diamonds, turquoise, silver, all these precious gems come from deep within her. She gives us all that we need, not only for our survival, but for our pleasure. It is our responsibility as keepers of the earth to take care of her. Although she could destroy us in a heartbeat, a snap of a finger, we could be gone. But she has promised us, and the Creator, that she would not destroy us because she loved us. She only asks that we remember to be thankful for what she gives us and not decay our own lives by polluting and destroying her, our mother. We must do all we can to alert others and to take the responsibilities as keepers of the earth. We need to teach others, and our children especially, our future generations, that they too have this special gift as being a keeper of the earth.